Hey everybody, my name is Casey Hall and I'm a music teacher here in Atlanta, Georgia. But for today, I'm pretending to be a professional chef and I'm gonna teach you how to cook with rhythms. Come along and join me. First things first, all good chefs know you need to have clean hands. So let's get to washing. There, all clean. Now let's get to cooking. For our rhythm recipe today, we're gonna need a couple of things. The first thing I need you to get is 4 plates, or 4 bowls, or 4 pots and pans, or even 4 napkins. We're gonna lay those out, 1, 2, 3, and 4, just like that. I'm gonna give you about 30 seconds to go run into your kitchen really quick and carefully and get those plates, bowls, or napkins. Here we go. Hey friends, great job at getting your plates or bowls or napkins or pots or pans or whatever you had around the house out for this lesson. We're going to use them to represent the beat in music. But what is the beat? Have you ever been listening to music and maybe you nodded your head to it without even thinking about it? Or maybe you tapped your foot? Or maybe you did some crazy dance moves to the beat? I don't know. That, my friends, is the steady beat. The steady beat never changes. It is the same. When we listen to music, we can feel that and we can hear that, and that is the steady beat. So we're going to use these plates to represent the beat. I'm going to use my fancy spatula, but you can use your hands. What I want you to do is to listen to me and see if you can find the steady beat. Once you found the steady beat, can you pat it on your laps maybe? Or can you tap it on your shoulders? Or maybe if you want to be silly and tap it on your head. Who knows? It's up to you. Can you find the steady beat? Listen up. Nice job. Did you guys hear that? I sure heard it and I felt it. Were you guys tapping along as we went? Awesome. Now what I want you to do is you can either go get a spatula or you can use your hands or maybe even a spoon and we are gonna keep the steady beat together using our plates. Are you ready? 1, 2, keep the beat. Oh yeah. Nice job, everybody. Keep it up. Oh yeah, oh yeah. And stop. Nice job, guys. We were really cooking with that beat today. Now what I want us to do is to keep it with some music. I have some music pulled up on my phone I think you're really gonna like. Will you join me in keeping the steady beat using your spatula or even your hands to keep the beat? Are you ready? Here we go. We'll be right back. Wow, everybody, that was so awesome. That music sounded really cool too. Did you feel the beat? Did you feel it in your body? Were you nodding your head? Were you moving your body like I was? I don't know about you, but that music made me feel good. I hope it made you feel good too. Now, we're gonna start cooking with some other things called rhythms. But before we do that, we are going to have to get some more ingredients. So now what I need you to do is I'm gonna give you about a whole minute to go run back into the kitchen and to gather some ingredients for our rhythm recipe. It could be anything. You could get spoons, forks, apples, oranges, fruits, grapes, vegetables, chips, candy, anything you can get that you can grab in your little hands and come run back to your plate so that we can get start cooking. That would be great. So on your mark, get set, let's go find some ingredients. Here we go. You, but I got a lot of tasty stuff from my kitchen, like oatmeal, sugar, peanut butter, mashed potatoes, coffee, popcorn, an apple, some chips. What else did I get? Some chocolate. Yeah, I got a bunch of stuff. What did you get? Well, that sounds amazing. I wish I could come to your house and eat some of your food. Okay, friends, now that we've collected all this delicious ingredients for our recipe today, we're gonna use them on our plates to represent rhythms in music. But what's a rhythm? Well, a rhythm is a pattern of long or short sounds or silences. Some sounds can sound long, some can sound short. Just depends. When we create music or when we listen to music, all of these patterns are mixed together in the sounds that we hear, and it creates music. It creates the things that we like to listen to. And the cool part about rhythm is it can change. It doesn't have to stay the same. Steady beat, like we learned, does have to stay the same. But what we put on top of the beat, the rhythm, that can change. So what we're going to do now is we are going to put some of these ingredients on top of our plates. And can anybody tell me what we said that the plates were representing? That's right, they are representing the steady beat. When we're talking about rhythms, rhythms live on top of the beat. They're connected, but they're not the same. So friends, now we're gonna take the items that we've collected and we're going to put them on top of the beat to create a rhythm. So for instance, I'm gonna pick up an apple. I love apples, they're one of my favorite fruits. And I'm gonna set it on this beat right here. So every time I point to this beat, we're gonna say apple. Can I say anything on these beats? Is there an apple on these beats? No, so we're gonna be quiet and not gonna say anything. So it's gonna look something like this. Watch and listen. Apple. 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 Nice. Thanks for listening. Now I can start adding another item to the plate. Let me see. What would be good with an apple? Maybe some honey. Apple and honey, that kind of sounds good. I'm gonna stick some honey on top of this beat. So every time I tap on this beat, we're gonna say honey. Is there any honey or apples on this plate or this plate? Nope, so we're gonna be quiet. So now we're gonna do it. Listen, apple, honey, apple, honey, apple, honey. Nice. Now I'm gonna add something else. Maybe some cheese. Cheese is so good. Everybody loves cheese. I'm gonna put cheese on this plate. So now we have an apple, we have honey, we have cheese, and we still don't have anything on this plate or this beet. So now we're gonna do it again. Can you do it with me this time? Here we go. Apple, honey, cheese. Apple, honey, cheese. Apple, honey, cheese. Apple, honey, cheese. Awesome. You guys are doing an amazing job. Now I need something to fill in this beat. Maybe some popcorn. Popcorn is one of my favorite snacks. I'll put popcorn on that plate. All right, you ready to do it together? Here we go. Apple, honey, cheese, popcorn. Apple, honey, cheese, popcorn. Apple, honey, cheese, popcorn. Now I want you to do it without me. Are you ready? One, two, here we go. Okay, everybody, you did a great job with that last activity. I think it was a little too easy. So we're gonna crank up the heat in this kitchen and we're gonna make an extra challenge for you. Are you ready? What we're gonna do next is we're going to say the items on the plates and we're gonna clap the name. For instance, apple. I'm gonna clap apple because apple makes two sounds. I need to clap twice, apple. Same thing for honey, honey. That's two syllables or two sounds. So now I'm gonna clap it twice. Same thing for cheese, but cheese makes one sound. So that means I can only clap once on cheese. Cheese. Then what we have? Popcorn. Popcorn. That's two sounds as well, so we need to clap twice. Popcorn. So we put that all together, and when we keep the steady beat, it sounds something like this. Listen to me first. Apple, honey, cheese, popcorn. Apple, honey, cheese, popcorn. Apple, honey, cheese, popcorn. Can you guys do it without me? I'm gonna point to the item and I want you to clap and say the rhythm. Are you ready? Here we go. Absolutely amazing. Give yourselves a round of applause. But you know what? I think we could take it up another level, even hotter. So now what we're gonna do, instead of saying it with our mouth, I want you to say it in your head. I want you to say those items in your head, and I want you to clap the name with your hands. So we're gonna say it in our heads, and we're gonna clap it in our hands. It's gonna look like this. So now it's your turn. I wanna see if you can do this. This is like the ultimate cooking with rhythms challenge. You guys ready? One, two, it's your turn. Rhythms change. Have we changed anything on our plates yet? No, but the cool thing is that we can change things on here. So I'm gonna take all of them off and I'm gonna make a completely different rhythm. It's gonna look something like this. So we have chips, coffee, milk, and rice. So we're gonna do those three things again. We're going to just say their names. Let's try it together. One, two, here we go. Chips, coffee, milk, rice, chips, coffee, milk, rice, chips, coffee, milk, rice, chips, coffee, milk, rice. Awesome. Now let's take it up to the second level. Let's clap it and say it at the same time. One, two, do it with me. Chips, coffee, milk, rice. Chips, coffee, milk, rice. Chips, coffee, milk, rice. Chips, coffee, milk, rice. Third level, are you ready? I want you to say it in your head and clap it in your hands. Say it in your head and clap it with your hands. Are you ready? One, two, here we go. Awesome, you guys are making rhythms and you're clapping them and you're reading them. That is amazing. So now friends, what if I didn't want to have an item on my plate? What if I ate all of my rice? So there was no more rice on that plate. What would happen to that plate? Do I just take the plate away? No, the plate's still there. There's still a beat there, right? So what we're gonna do, we're gonna put our finger to our mouth like this because we can't say or clap anything on this beat because there's nothing on the plate, right? So it's gonna look like this. Chips, coffee, milk. Chips, coffee, milk. Chips, coffee, milk. Chips, coffee, milk. See? It's still there, it's just silent. And that's another cool thing about rhythm. Sometimes composers or musicians don't want to play or compose the sound, so they put silence in there instead. I could do that again. Maybe I want to take my coffee away. I already had my morning coffee this morning, so I'm gonna put that away for right now. Now we just have chips, silence, milk, and silence again. Remember, rhythms can change and you can make it however you want to do. So, let's do this. Chips, milk, chips, milk, chips, milk. Okay, everyone, the next thing we're gonna do is practice, and you get to practice with your items that you brought from your kitchen. So, here's what you need to do. One item per plate, so you can only put one item on here. Can I do this? Put honey and coffee? No, I can only choose one. Maybe I can put honey here and coffee here. That's totally cool because that's one and that's one, but you can't put two on one plate, okay? I'm gonna give you about 30 seconds to do that. Okay, I can't see your plates at home, but I'm gonna pretend that I see all of your plates filled with your items. Remember, one per plate. So now what I want you to do is say your items. Okay, are you ready? One, two, here we go. Now let's take it to the second level. Let's clap your items and say it with your mouth. Are you ready? One, two, your turn, go. Whoa. You're doing awesome. Keep it up. And stop. Guys, I am so impressed right now about how well you're doing with this activity. Okay, last level. You have to clap it with your hands, say it inside of your head. Clap it with your hands and say it inside your head. One, two, here we go. Keep it going. Amazing. Guys, I am so super impressed at how well you did at this activity. Keep going. I have something else to show you next. You ready? Okay, friends, for the last part of our lesson today, we're gonna go back to the first rhythm that we created together. Apple, honey, cheese, popcorn. Apple, honey, cheese, popcorn. You remember that, right? So what we're gonna do now is we're going to replace the item with the word that goes with it. Now, as you can see, it's still the same word, even though we don't see the item anymore. It's still apple, because it makes two sounds, honey, because it makes two sounds, cheese, that makes one sound, and popcorn makes two sounds as well. If we can recognize how many sounds a word makes, like cheese makes one sound, we can actually match that up with a rhythm symbol in music. Some of these symbols that you're about to see, you might have seen in your own music classrooms. Can you remember what some of them are? Like we were saying, cheese makes one sound, and there's a rhythm symbol that also makes one sound, and it is called a quarter note. It makes one sound on one beat. Have you recognized something like that before? What about apple? Apple, like you can see, makes two sounds, apple. So we have to find a rhythm symbol that matches two sounds. And luckily, we have one. Look something like this, and that's one, two. This is a paired eighth note, and it's a pair because it is two of them. Like you have a pair of jeans where you have two legs to fit in, right? Or a pair of shoes, that's two things you have to put on each shoe. But a paired eighth note gets one beat, not two beats, one beat, but it makes two sounds. So we have a paired eighth note and a quarter note. What about honey? Honey makes two sounds as well. Is it going to be like apple, or is it going to be like cheese? Cheese makes one sound, apple makes two sounds. What about honey? It also makes two sounds. What's it going to be? Right. Honey is going to make two sounds just like apple, and it is also a paired eighth note. Because honey makes two sounds and apple makes two sounds, it's the same kind of notes, and it's a paired eighth note. What about popcorn? Popcorn, that also makes two. Is it going to be the same as honey, or is it going to be the same as cheese? You guys are so smart. It's going to be like honey. It makes two sounds, and this is also a paired eighth note. So we have a paired eighth note, quarter note, and a paired eighth note. Have you noticed any of these in your music classroom? If you have, your music teacher may call them different things like TT or ta or ta-di or one and. It just depends, and they're all correct. But for today, we're gonna call a quarter note ta. So every time you see a note that looks like this, you're gonna say ta. And every time you see a paired eighth note, you're gonna say ta d, because that makes two sounds. Ta d makes two and ta makes one. So if I was going to read this rhythm now, I wouldn't say apple, honey, cheese, popcorn. I would say the rhythm syllables like ta d or ta. So it's gonna sound like this. Ta di ta di ta, ta di ta di ta di ta, ta di. Can you do it without me? One, two, here you go. That's awesome, guys. You're reading a rhythm that you guys helped me create today, and that is awesome. I got one more thing to teach you. Remember when I said that I could take an item off the plate and that plate would be silent because there's nothing there? The same thing can happen in music. If I take a sound off of a beat, it becomes a silent beat. I didn't take the beat away, I just made it silent. And in music, we call that a rest. Rests are silent beats that don't make. Just like when you rest at home in your bed, you're most likely silent, right? So when we read this, when we get to this beat right here, we can't make any sound. And here's another funny thing about rests. They have a funny looking symbol that looks like this. It kind of looks like a lightning bolt, doesn't it? When we see this symbol, we're gonna put our finger over our mouth to represent the silent beat. So watch me as I read this rhythm now using the rhythm symbols. One, two, here we go. Toddy, ta, toddy, toddy, ta, toddy, toddy, ta, toddy. So now that we're pros at this rhythm, let's make another rhythm using these rhythm symbols. Okay, so now, because I mixed them up, there's a new rhythm. It's gonna sound different because I moved the order of the rhythm symbols. So now it's gonna sound like this. One, two, here we go. Ta, toddy, toddy, ta, toddy, toddy, ta, toddy, toddy, ta, toddy, toddy. Let's make another one. Ooh, look at all these. All of these have those paired eighth notes. Is that okay? Totally. When you're writing rhythms, there's no wrong answer because that's your creative mind that you get to put into your music. Let's read this one together. One, two, here we go. Toddy, 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 toddy. You guys are awesome. Last challenge, everybody. What if you found something in your kitchen that didn't have one sound, two sounds, or three sounds? What if there was something in your kitchen that had four sounds, something like peanut butter or an avocado? Those have four sounds. Avocado, peanut butter. But how does that look like in music? Well, instead of just having two sounds like the paired eighth notes, sounds that have four look like this in music. This is a beamed 16th note. That sounds a very fancy word for something very simple. It just means that there's four sounds that get one beat. Four sounds on one beat. And just like we called this a paired eighth note, and when we read it, we called it a toddy, we're gonna call this a takadimi, because that makes four sounds. I know it sounds super silly, but we're gonna do it anyway, okay? So can we read this new rhythm with our takadimi right here? It's gonna sound something like this. Toddy, toddy, takadimi, toddy. Toddy, toddy, takadimi, toddy. That sounds pretty cool. Let's mix it up one last time. Here we go. Okay, you guys ready? This is it. This is our final rhythm we're doing today. We have takadimi, toddy, a rest. Remember, we do over our lips. And then we have ta. Let's say it together. One, two, here we go. Takadimi, toddy, ta. Takadimi, toddy, ta. Takadimi, toddy, ta. Takadimi, toddy, ta. You guys are awesome. All right, friends, that's all the time we have for today, unfortunately. I've had so much fun creating music with you and cooking with rhythms with things we can find even in our own kitchens. What else can you find around your house that you could use to make music with? The possibilities are endless, and I'm sure your parents are gonna love that. My challenge to you is to continue to make music no matter where you are. Music is everywhere. Thanks for tuning in. And see you later. Bye.